Just so that we give everybody a chance to ask questions, please raise your hand for questions and ask one question at a time. If we have time for a second, we'll come back for that.
Coach, my name is Lewambaro from Manifest State. I just want to find out with you. You added five players into your squad. Talk to us about it.
Yeah, no. Over into the squad or into the starting lineup? I didn't mean five players.
Yes, the squad that you're about to announce.
There's seven uncapped players in the squad, but the five that joined.
Yes.
You mean that joined the camp?
Yes.
Oh, but those were the guys who were at the line in camps, and we've always planned for them to be part of this week's what happens. I'm just two questions, sorry about that. We were hoping to, after the second win against Ireland, which we didn't get, we were really hoping to give the other guys the rest and to give these young guys who's had alignment camps with us a chance. I feel one drop goal shouldn't change your whole mindset and your whole over emotional and not do it. So all of those guys, they deserve to be here. Sorry for that answer.
Rassie, just maybe do you have an update on Franco Mostert and maybe Kanan Rudy as well?
Yeah, Kanan will be ready next week, as I understand. I'm 100% ready. Franco is 6 weeks. I think he broke his leg. Malcolm, I just said now he's got a little bit of a tibia fracture there when he got injured. And who's the other one? Edwell is out for 6 weeks. And also another one, Peter Steff, looks like he's 4 to 6 weeks. But Albi looks like ready for the second week of Australia, but part obviously from the guys, I said 6 weeks.
But just to follow on that, that obviously makes some of the younger guys here, more, their roles more important this week, given the injuries.
Yeah, we would love him to follow up, see, not as the similar mode, style of play. We don't have a typical open side. He's been living almost with Sia, trying to understand what he's doing, and you know Sia's strength is ball carrying and blasting and rucks and really clean out well, and Sia can steal balls as well, and obviously likes to help Don in the scrums, and it's not really a line-up jumping option, and I think he's got the mould and the body to do that, so hopefully we can get that out of him. And then Ben Jason Dixon is somebody that's very similar to Peter Steff, you know, in the way he plays. You'll see that the Ruanas on the bench, who's not a typical lock, but he's definitely got the body for somebody who can play front lock and seven flank, and you might do some height then, but then you've got Ben Jason, who can probably call the lineups for you if Ergio or Salman is not on the field. So we've tried to do our succession planning, and we've tried to do it that loss against Ireland doesn't influence our mindset, like we did in 2020, when we didn't have rugby, we would have done the same thing. Now we get the opportunity, now we must stick with it.
Rassie, welcome back in Bloom.
Thanks.
A couple of debutants, as has been mentioned already, but two that really stand out. Andre, you're competitive, you know his pedigree. So as a coach, is it pretty exciting to be able to name a kid like this on the bench? Especially, if I remember correctly, he played with his dad. And then Jan Hendrik Wessels, another kid from Bloom, also a big opportunity for him this weekend.
Yeah, the fact that, you know, I also had a father. He didn't play great rugby, but he told me he played Cossais League there at the Onderwijs College in Graafrenet. I think he was also proud of me. So I think his father, I think everybody's father, you know, but he is great. Me and Andre played almost 30 test matches together, I think, as flankers. Also 6 and 7. I think that's where the trend started in South Africa, where we didn't play open side and blind side. I think we were like the first guys, I think, like, who was it? Nick Mallet put us 6 and 7. So it's great for him. It doesn't, but it looks like it happens often. You know, I think, I don't know how many guys has fathers has played Springbok and then the son does it as well. But then Jan Hendrik Wessels, I think they're the same age. I think they played next to one another. He's somebody that we're really, really excited about. I think he's somebody that you can look for at the World Cup who you might not even have to take five props. You can take four hookers if you want to. And, you know, then you can maybe take one old hooker still with if a guy like him can swing on both sides. But we're going to play him prop. this weekend where he's comfortable, where he always plays for our EBD systems. But and Grobbies, we're very excited about him. He's been waiting and waiting and waiting, and always somebody gets a chance before him with most of the players. And yeah, I can go on through the list, and I think every single player should be proud. It's a proper test match in Bloemfontein in front of a sellout crowd.
And sorry, just on the sold-out crowd, it's incredible for the people to come out and support the team for so-called lower-tier nation.
Well, it's a team that, when I spoke to the Irish boys Saturday, I went to the change room and just said, I said, not that I think we're too sure, I spoke to most of them and said, you know, we're playing Portugal, and I said, don't underestimate them, they actually beat them before the World Cup. That was the first thing they said, and then the second thing, you know, they beat Fiji in the World Cup. We obviously analysed them. It's going to be a busy game. We're going to be all over the field. I think they're going to run away from our set pieces and try and move us around. That's definitely a fact. But the sellout crowd, to come back to that, that makes it, I think, special for a guy like Jan Indre Wessels and the guys who was at Grey and Andre Hugo. It's special for me every single time. I remember when in 90, whatever it was built, I always used to go and sit in this pavilion, and I thought, I want to play one day for the Free State on this field. And then they built the pavilion, and I remember the first match played there. So for me, it's special. The old stadium, Bloemfontein, is special. And I guess even more for those guys.
Rassie, can you ask
me
my wife in this question? First of all, congratulations to this team that you selected for this coming test match. Just remind us again, what are you hoping to get out of this test match with this group of players? And the second part of my question is, Rassie, coaches in general, I'm not talking about rugby specifically in general, they're usually very sensitive when you refer to a team as a potential B-side. Would you take offense if I refer to your Springbok side for this weekend as a B-side, sir?
Let me answer the. I can't see you, Percy. That light right in my eye. I have no idea where you are, but I can hear you, and it's weird that you asked the English question. In a nice, friendly way, this is not. If you compare Fassi with Sasha, and you compare Kirtley Spring, and you compare Lucanu and Jesse, and Andre, and Damien, and Marnie, and Sasha or Damien Willems or Marnie and Kubas actually played in the World Cup semifinals. Well, they were the pairing there. Then if you go, so Kubas I've mentioned, you compare Kubas with the other guys, he played in the World Cup semi. Then Ivan Ruiz, everybody actually last week thought we should start him above Quagga and maybe keep Quagga off the bench. Then Ben Jason Deakins, I just told you, I think he's not far off when it comes to a guy like Peter Steff, the way he play. We've just talked about Pepsi, then Ergen from Mans in the team, which played last week. And then Thomas de Toy is somebody that's been to one World Cup, and everybody knows how well he did for Bath now. I'm not going to go into a replacement. So the two young guys probably in there is him and Johan Grobler and Jan Hendrik Wessels and a few guys on the bench. Then you've got Trevor Niakane, you've got Tux, you've got Elric Lowe who's been with us, Sasha, and then a few other guys. So, no, it's not a B team. It's a team that I thought if they played last week against Ireland, it would have been a tight test match. And we said it to the other guys as well before the test match. And that's what we want. We want in each position two guys, experienced guys who push each other, and a young guy knocking on the door who wants to come through all the time. And we didn't, I know I say it all the time, we didn't have a 2020 to do that. We have a 2024 now where we can do it, but we know we're going to have speed bumps like Saturday, which is not lucky to face. But now I forgot your first question, but I answered your second question, sorry.
Sorry, the first part of my question was just, you kind of answered it, what are you hoping to get out of this?
Yeah, I'm hoping for these guys to be proud and to know that even SCB's 120 caps, there's a Namibia somewhere in there, and there's a Romania somewhere in there, and there's a... So a test cap is a test cap. These guys beat Fiji and they beat Ireland in a Chakas warm-up game. So if one of them take it up lightly, first of all, we'll see that guy's not test material. That's the first thing. The second thing is you play in, according to me, one of the big provinces which probably create a lot of young players that come through, especially from the school and the varsity, and then it's going to be a sellout crowd. So I expect them, we expect them, they expect from themselves to represent themselves as Springboks and a team that's number one in the world.
Are there any strategies or tactics that you're looking to implement against Portugal? And second, how do you ensure team maintains the momentum against throughout the matches?
Yeah, there's definitely certain moves and things that we're going to try. They're going to have some time. The scrums will start the same. We will try just to dominate the scrums. It's not always that easy. And then in the lineouts, they have different challenges than Ireland. Ireland is probably one of the top teams when it comes to lineouts in the world. It always baffles you how well Paul O'Connell can do the lineouts. So there we have certain plans. Sorry, your last question?
That the team maintains their
fitness within. The nice thing is these guys, a lot of them that don't play, and they've been training a hell of a lot, and some of them playing for their franchises and for their provinces. Ben Jason Dixon has now been with us 5 weeks, 4 weeks, and is at all the training camps, and he was, I promise you, he knows everything. He did the line-out for the opposition against us. Marcus Zolo has been always with us. So I think this team is very hungry, and they deserve a chance, and they've been waiting very long. So I don't think it would be a problem for them to pitch up.
Rassie, good morning.
Morning.
Just talk us through Salman Murat's appointment as captain and the political significance of it, because Salman is from a very rich rugby heritage, a rugby family. That's very big in this region. You'd say you could partly say that about the Hudson, but did you also have that in mind in picking him as captain?
No, I did not. You know, when a guy phones you, the Stormers was playing away, and a guy sends you a WhatsApp and he says, I just flew over, and he didn't tell me this part I found out later. He flew over on his own cost, and he went and asked me, they played Munster, because he knew I coached Munster, and he asked me, what can he help, because he's going to watch the match, and I thought he was with the team, and, you know, he was the team captain at that stage, but he didn't play, and he asked me, what can he do to, maybe I know something about Munster that can help the team, and, we didn't chat a lot, but then to find out later, you know, he actually flew over on his own cost, and wasn't even in the team, because he was injured at that stage, he was a week away from playing. And working with him in the junior box, all the management members who's been working with him in the junior box, he's just captain material, you know. So it's great that it's coming from an area that will mean a lot to that area. That's awesome. That's not the reason why we pick him. We picked him because he's a great leader, and even with these big locks here, who has won World Cups, you know, he doesn't stand back physically or tactically when it gets to line out. So, well deserved team.
Yeah, Pepsi, I was actually going to go to you. This has been a long time coming for you. You were in Kimberley last week in that game against the Greek quiz after being given some time off. How does it feel to finally see your name on the official test list to make the debut?
Yeah, no, it's very special for me and my family. It's obviously been a childhood dream of mine to represent the Springboks and to play for South Africa. So it's a dream come true for me, and it's really a game that me and my family are really looking forward to.
First, can I ask you, Rassie, to spoke about the leaders in the squad, and your coach has been very clear over the past couple of weeks that they don't only look at one leader in the squad, they want even the youngest player, the most unsure player, to perform as a leader in the squad. You are a leader in Durban at the Sharks. What has experience been so far for you playing with some of these players, and what are you hoping to get out of this first test match against Portugal this week?
Yeah, for me personally, the experience has been amazing. Like Coach said, I've really leaned on a guy like Sia, Kwaha, Marku. Those guys have really helped me. I've been with the team. I've had the privilege of being with the team now for the past couple of weeks, so I've really learned a lot from them, and I've also realized that even though Sia is the captain, but there are many leaders within the group, and everyone is just always helping to try and make the boat go faster, and that's something I've also learned, and I want to try and implement going forward.
Do you guys understand that Portugal could be a potential banana peel this coming weekend?
Please explain banana peel.
Slippery game, like
yeah. So like coach said, I think Portugal are really on an upward curve. They obviously beat Ireland and Fiji in the World Cup, so I think they'll really come out guns blazing. I think for them as well, it'll be a massive game, you know, playing the world champions. So it's certainly not a game that we're taking lightly.
Coach, you went to social media to apologize to South Africans after your game.
Yep.
Yes, and then now the question becomes, how has the team preparation been leading to this upcoming game, and what are your key strategies to this one after your apology on social media?
Yeah, the apology was actually to congratulate Ireland. Because I thought the way they went the second half, of the first half, they played brilliant rugby. And then I thought our team really played well for the next 35 minutes. And then the last 2 minutes we played not as smart as we could. And for them to guts it out at the end of their season, a long season, they've played the whole Six Nations, they've played, and they came over to us to level the series is well done. And then for our team, we never want to drop the fans. So the apologize is just because we lost. And I guess after the first test match, if you ask me, what are we going to do different to win? You know, nobody asked me that. So, you know, so we'll just make plans in the lineouts and plans in the scrum and on the defense and make sure the boys are all on the same page and respect the Portugal team who's coming here, respect the fans and put up a gutsy effort, lots of effort and lots of determination and hopefully a good result for the fans at the stadium, but also for all the people in South Africa.
Thank
you. One more question, Coach. What role do you see senior players playing in mentoring these young players?
Yeah, we've got a thing. We say, oh, we don't have, yeah, this day senior player, player. potato peelers. They're senior players, but they are the more the older guys. But in our team, it doesn't work like that. If you a 20-year-old and you take ownership and you take ownership of your position, of your priority in the team, of what you must do, of your responsibility in the team, on the field, off the field, you know, in the meeting sessions, then you don't have to be an old guy to be a leader in our team. We take ownership, and if you take enough ownership, that's why we're not afraid to throw young guys in. If we get a young guy here and he struggles to take ownership, he doesn't have to take leadership. He can just be influential. He doesn't have to be a leader. Then we'll give him a chance. And this group, I think most of them, no, I don't think, I know, all of them, he's got ownership.
Twickenham was probably the first, and Ireland's now out of the way. This match is also to start off towards 2027. It's sort of trials and looking for players for 2027.
Yes, for 2027. Sorry, I thought you meant the end of 2024. Look, Ireland was, although people think, and we're all disappointed that we didn't beat them 2-0, but Ireland are a very, very good team. And it was a good start to try and see some of the old guys. And I guess one of the questions we must be asking ourselves, why did the guys only come right in the second half? You know those quick questions can be answered by the guys playing this weekend. Can they pitch for the first minute and we don't have to half-time wind them up to get ready for the second half? Do you, at what age do you get too old to get to the next World Cup? So maybe some of the guys will understand that we're now going to give other guys a chance, because if you're not going to pitch from the start, we can't make you pitch from the start. You know, we can coach you, we can help you, we can believe in you, and then you must be able to get yourself up after a big test match like that, and then in the next big test match. So yes, we're starting now, and we're thinking these boys can play in 2027, and will a guy like Malcolm Marx still be there in 2027? Let's see. Grobbies, show us what you have. Jan Hendrik, Andre Jugu, Shawa, Salman, Eben, will you still be there in 2027? Or if you're not, Salman, will you make it? Exactly what you say, that's more or less what we're trying to do from now to the future.
Let's take two more English questions, then we move on.
Pepsi, I just wanted to ask, Coach mentioned the opportunity that is, you know, being paired with a senior player that is, the opportunity that you've been given, how has that impacted your game from the level you are coming now?
Yeah, I think from just being with the squad, seeing how the guys train, how they prepare going into a test match, you know, the amount of detail that really goes into it and the planning behind the scenes, I think that's really been massive for me, and it's something I'm going to take back. Obviously, when I go back and I join my franchise, it's just that standard of professionalism that I've experienced here, I'll really look to implement into my game going forward.
One in English and then
you go over there. Rassie, just talk us through the selections of Quan Horn and
Mornay van den Berg. Yeah, we were actually itching to give Mornay van den Berg. If Fav had a bit of a nail, and Grant is always awesome off the bench. We know Grant and Jaden has won a World Cup. They've been there. And they won't be old in 2027. And they will have a World Cup behind them. So we know Grant and Jaden will be there. Jaden is, I saw him in Durban. He's 2 weeks away from playing, 3 weeks. Then Krappies or Morray is his real name. For us, his technical skills are just really on the same level of all the other guys. So I think Kubis and Faf really has some nice pressure from the bottom there. And then Jaden and Grant really has some nice pressure. I mean it positive. I mean, listen, we are five guys. You can be nines for South Africa, you know. Maybe they'll take five next time, not four. I'm joking. It's... And then Kuan Horn has just been so solid. I think he'll put some nice pressure in a good way on Fassi. Because Fassi, you know, it would have been lovely. We saw how Sasha can play 10. You know, he can play 12. He played 15 on Saturday. When Gaza comes back, he can play 10, 12, and 15. And now we've got Fassi, who can play wing and fullback. And we've got Kuan Horn, who can play fullback. So I think it's nice pressure, but positive pressure. Not, listen, yeah, if you don't do well, we're going to throw you away. We're going to help you get better.
Right, guys, Afrikaans and Zulu?
Ja, sure. Dis natuurlik nie die enigste rede hoekom ek Salman gekies het nie. Salman kom deur ons EPD systems. Ons ken hom al baie goed. En as jy die Kaapse se mense ken, is die Murat familie. Is 'n bekende rugby familie en nou weet hulle is amper soos iets weet in die in geval. Maar hy het my geëindig op WhatsApp en sê kan ek 'n bietjie iets vertel van Munster. En ek vroeg hom terug, wat kan ek hom vertel? Wil hy weet hoe is dit daar? Is die weer wat want hy het nie gespeel die naweek nie. En toe het my WP Stommers teen Munster gespeel en hy het oorgevlieg en ek het later toe gehoor hy het met sy eie geld oorgevlieg en op sy eie oorgevlieg net om die span te gaan ondersteun en hy wou vir 'n paar woorde gaan gee om en baie wil 'n bietjie background hee, om te weet wat kan hy vir hulle sê wat ek volgens my by Munster gecoach. So ja, so iets steek binne iets vas in ou se kop, jy weet, dis my ouens wat gewoonlik gaan die ouens op 'n ski vakansie saam met sy vrou, sy het 'n gebreekte been of iets het, of 'n been is, seker geen ski nie. Of hy gaan op 'n Mauritius toe saam met sy girlfriend of wat ook al en vat 'n breek. Nee, hy klim op die vliegtuig, hy soek 'n bietjie info, hy wil die span gaan help. Ek is mal oor as hy in sulke goeders. Meneer Rasmus,
kan ek vir ons vraag, net kortliks, wat hoop julle om wyser te word met hierdie span wat julle gekies vir die naaste tyd?
Joernalis
se
spoes vir jongs sal verwys na jou span as naaste bestes op hierdie span. Dit lyk my duidelik Rassie wat hierdie dit doen. Persie, ek het jou 'n lang pad van die Kaap af. Ja, ek is nie seker. Do you want me to say me and Persie are different views that this is a B team playing and of okay. Wil jy ek moet sê ek verskil met Percy dat hierdie nie 'n A-B span is nie. Would like that said first? Okay. Persie, nee, dis 'n beespan nie. Ek dink as hierdie ouens Saterdag, laas Saterdag teen Nederland gespeel het, sou hulle naby Iran ook naby gedruk het en kon gewen het. Hier's regtig min ouens wat heeltemal uit die koue uitkom, wat hier inkom. Baie van hulle was al in alignment camps gewees. Natuurlik is Jan Hendrik Wessels nie Oxygen, maar wie sê oor 4 games gaan Jan Hendrik Wessels nie vir Oxygen bietjie Steven Kujastrin Kitsoff is ook naby terugkom, ek vergeet om dit te sê. So Jan Hendrik Wessels en hy kan haker en loskop speel. Jy weet, Andre Igoventer en Grobbies. Joseph Dweber, laatste jaar sy kans gekry, ek vind van 4 toetse. Ons het al gesien wat hy kan doen. Miskien kom hierdie twee ouens en sit helse pressure op Bongie en Malcolm. En dit is selfe met Pepsi, as hy pressure op. So, jong, hierdie is een baie goeie span. En ek dink as hierdie span tegen laasweekse span moet speel, sal daar nie een baie groot telling verskil wees tussen dit nie. Ek hoop het antwoord is.
Kan jy so?
Nee, jy wel. Portugal is een toets, ons moet wen. Jy weet, ons, dit tel is nog een cap, en is een span wat vreselik graag die wereldkampioene sal wil omdop, op hulle thuis in Suid-Afrika. Hier is een klomp Portugese vriende van my, hier so in Bloemfontein. Ek het 18 jaar geblei in Bloemfontein, ek ken Bloemfontein baie goed. Kijk hier die rooie kolle wat ek al klaar uitslaan van die kouwe hier so. En ek ken die mense baie goed, en ek weet hulle gaan baie support hee, en ek weet dat een klomp mense, een klomp loosies en goeders gekry. So, dit gaan een lekker vibe wees, en is een skitterende span, en ek dink het gaan een blerrie vinnige game wees, omdat dit die manier is wat hulle speel, en ek sal like het ons stempel kan afdruk op die manier hoe ons wil speel Saterdag.
Kan
jy
so?
Schenke, dis is gaat wat jy daar maar ons ook gaan, wat jy nie nie nie, wat jy laat nie nie kaya, en wat jy nie nie maar beso, wat jy nie nie, wat jy nie nie, wat jy nie nie, wat jy nie
nie. Si jelwe zolo, ay pembel zolala, gule mbela sende sagion, ngaba fone le kaya, abajabula kakhulu ekhaya njengoba ngishilo ukuthi lokhu kusho lukhulu emndenini wami angicansi ngizoba umuntu oqala emndenini wami ukuthi ngibe yibhokobhoko so kusho lukhulu and yithuba elibalulekile kakhulu lelo emndenini wami
bekunjani batshele ba hayi sengitshele manje ningatshele bantu bekunjani babatshele bahambe ngoba bangavundisa umyalezo
ya angithembi ukuthi bangilalelile isikhathi ngibatshela lokho kodwa bebejabule kakhulu yabona angicansi uma uze wakhala ngesikhathi ezo so bekusho lukhulu kuyena ngebhadi-ke ubaba kaseke emhlabeni kodwa naye ngiyazi ukuthi lapha akhona njengamanje uyasiqhenya
awusibigabantu ababa wakho nendlela uyihambile suzofika la uqala khona uphuma kwakho uzadlala kahle kakhulu i-DHS uzofika la ukhoyo manje
also ayigama likababa wami uSimon Buthelezi owashona ngo-2008 ngifunde mina e-DHS eDurban High School la engarepresenta khona iKwaZulu Natal kwi-Craven Week emva kwalokho ngathola ithuba ukuthi ngidlale i-SA Schools emva kwe-SA Schools ngajoyina iqembu lama-Sharks la engasayina khona i-contract ngathola nanethuba ukuthi ngidlalele ama-Junior Springboks ngonyaka wami wokuqala out of elokhuzeni esikoleni ngonyaka wami wesibili ngathola nanethuba elikhulu ukuthi ngibe umholi wama-Junior Springboks nalokho kwasho likhulu emndenini wami kwakuyisikhathi esihle kakhulu leso lesi sikhathi sami sokudlala ngaqhubeka ngadlala kuma-Sharks njengoba sengithola ithuba lokuthi ngidlalele amabhokobhoko amabhokobhoko i-team esithanda kakhulu ekhaya angiyakhumbula uma wayehlezi ewabuka wonke amagame e-World Cup usebazi bonke abadlali wayemthanda kakhulu uPollard ethi uPollard akageji so angicanthi kuyena kuzoba nje i-weekend enhle kakhulu abazobe bekhona emdlalweni ukuza wonke umndeni wami so kuzobe isikhathi esihle nje sokuthi nami ngikwazi ukuthi ngibamele njengomndeni wakwaButhelezi
awuthi ngibuza kuyena awusho-ke mfethu ngathi lushaza vele ulukubhekile ukuthi
isikhathi sakho sokuqala ukuthi uyithole nawe udlala kule kule ngqebe namhlanje kule mpela veki ungathi kule lusha elingathi nalo liyayidinga le opportunity ukuthi baze bakhone ukuthi bangababoni nje kodwa mabona kude badlale nabo abosina kanjalo ungathini kule lusha la Life Free State?
Yeah, ngingathi akulentsha Life Free State kubalulekile ukuthi usebenze kanzima wazi ukuthi yonke into oyifisayo ngenhliziyo yakho konke amaphupho nawo ayafezeka mawusebenza ngokusikhandla. Ngifuna yonke intsha yala e-Free State ama bezokwazi ukuze egameni beze ukuze bezothola i-experience yokuthi njani ukubukela amabhokobhoko mawukhona ngaphakathi enkundleni. Ngifuna bonke bephuphe ukuthi bazi futhi ukuthi kuyenzeka ukuthi ngelinye ilanga ugcina usufikile na wadlala amabhokobhoko uma usebenza ngokusikhandla futhi ungayeki ukuphupha noma yini oyifuna enhlizweni yakho uvuke njalo ekuseni awusebenze kanzima kungenzeka.
Anomie, excuse, ek weet ons tyd is op. Daar is nog 'n stukkie geskiedenis wat gemaak word.
Ja.
Met
Dolly Davidson
na die game
blaas.
Dis die
eerste
keer wat
jy 'n
vroue ref het.
Net 'n bietjie
kommentaar daarop. Jou ervaring.
Dis
die
eerste
keer
wat Ek maak 'n grapjie nie. Ja, ek vaar die olie baie goed. Sien Afrikaans Engels.
Net
so. Ja, she's a good ref. We are very excited to for the first time be refereed and handled by a referee on this stage and with this team. And yeah, congrats to her to do that. And yeah, for us, like last weekend, you know, we had no problems with the referee. And I think we're starting to get over that itch that we always had, a needle with the referees. Jakub Piper is certainly doing a lot. And there's some interesting facts that he's already told us about her. So now we're ready for the way she referees.
Last question over there.
Ngo zwani zokuthengisa kuwena, uzwenze i-deal yakho ngomgqibelo and into esiyizile ukuthi ama-tickets sewa sold out. Ngifuna ukuthi sikhulume ngendlela yakho manje ukuthi uzizwa njani and also from ama-players lawa amanye abusiya kulisi. Maybe khuluma nawe in terms of ukuprepare, how is it standing
bonke abadlali esikwadini sebengisize kakhulu kakhulukazi uSiya Kolisi uKwaga Smith nano Marco van Staden sebe bahlalile phansi nami bangichazele yonke into engifuna ukuyazi. So la ngikhona njengamanje sewukuthi sengizoletha nami igame yami ngilethe umfutho wami nami njengoba ngizobe ngidlala ngomgqibelo. Kungijabulisile kakhulu futhi ukuze i-stadium sizobe sigcwele. Ngiyajabulela kakhulu ukudlala phambi kwe-stadium esigcwele kakhulu. Ngiyathanda ukuthi ngijabulise abantu ngendlela engidlala ngayo and ngiyazi futhi ukuthi leli qembu esinalo sonke siyakujabulela lokho and futhi siyazi ukuthi igame ibalulekile kakhulu leli la ezweni lethu akakhulukazi thina njengamabhokobhoko ngoba simele iNingizimu Afrika.
Thank you. Thank you very much.